things in Scrum? What is the starting point? What's the starting point? What is the point to form a team when we don't have the product vision? What's the point? We start with product backlog. What is product backlog? Any idea?
Things to be done.
Things to be done.
List of requirements.
There's a difference in task and features. Just to clarify, so that you can relate for our further discussion.
User requirements.
User point of view. All the requirements which are point of from the point of user. And what makes a product by backlog good? What is the characteristic of a good product backlog?
It should be prioritized.
What else?
It should be small. I mean, it should not be a bigger feature or task.
We have everything in the product backlog.
Yeah, she is coming to the user stories, but yeah, this is
product. We have everything. You're right. But there is something to add. We are having everything which is related to the product. Everything. X, Y, Z, anything. Which forms the product.
Any requirement, it can.
It could be defect also, which is related to the, which is written from the user point of view, if customer captured it. So anything which is from the user point of view, it is there. Now, Scrum is a framework. Scrum doesn't tell what should be the format of these work. Scrum doesn't tell. Anything from which we can build the product, it should be there. Now, we are not forecasting our future, so we are not doing detailed planning. Whatever things we are going to take in near future, only those things are small. Other things should be big. That's why we say it, prioritize. Got the answer? What other?
Value.
Okay, there is a good acronym DEEP. D means detail appropriately. Write it if you don't know. Detail appropriately. Meaning of detailed appropriately? I have explained it already. Can you explain it? Can you echo my comment?
Shouldn't be too much confidence.
What is this?
It should not be detailed one.
Okay, where?
I mean, it should just meet the business requirement, and it should not be detailed one, so that we should concentrate on more on.
Everything is here, and we are focused. We are detailing the work which is going to be developed in near future. detailed appropriately. So only appropriate features has to be detailed. Or which one are appropriate? Which one are appropriate? Which are up. Which are at the up, because product backlog is prioritized.
The topmost should be detailed.
Yes. So if you are here, these tasks are like this. When you are here, these tasks are like this. When you are here, these tasks are like this. In size. Emergent. What was the problem of waterfall? We were baselining the requirements. We were baselining the design documents. And we were taking changes as exception. You want this change? Here's the change request. And here we know, we accepted it, that changes are part of life. So how we are going to handle changes, it's automatically taken care of. We don't need extra. This fact, because we have accepted it, this fact will be taken care of. That's why product backlog is emergent. Emergent. Never baseline, never frozen. Detailed appropriately, estimated, emergent, and prioritized. Now, item at the top are estimated differently sometimes. If SQL is not saying anything about it, it said it should be estimated. But when we when things gets evolved, we gets to know the things. We also aware gets aware about our the problems, errors in our estimates. Make sense?
Yeah, 1 minute. What is the third E?
Yeah, that's the estimator.
Emergent,
so first is this thing, detailed appropriately, estimatable, emergent, and prioritized.
Usable. It's very broad term.
Potential.
Potential. Usable means duration. I'm talking about, it's not abstract for when I talk about if I can use it or not. I'm talking about duration. So how you can judge that, okay, this duration is usable by the customer? What is the point here? We have to do little bit of everything: requirement, design, development, testing, and some we need to deliver something. We have to do something in this, that box, in this container, right? So it should not be long enough that people get sleep. It should not be so small that nothing can be developed. It should be small enough so that it creates a sense of urgency. It creates a focus environment. And if you are doing rudimentary work, I should not say rudimentary work, if you are in pretty stable environment, your sprint duration could be 30 days long. But if you revalidate your steps frequently, then you may come up with 2 weeks of time. If you are doing something very new, you have to revalidate your steps frequently. So here point is that for how much time I can live without customer feedback. Scrum gives you the faster feedback. It gives you a container where you produce something to get customer feedback. Now, at what time you need customer feedback? On the basis of that, you decide. There are many factors which comes under this discussion. When client is available, what kind of product we are developing, and how much time we can live without customer feedback. On the basis of that, this sprint duration is decided. Now, how sprint is started? Through the sprint planning meeting. And how? So, okay, I should talk about the roles first. Roles, what are the roles? Product owner. Scrum Master Development Team. Okay. What are the responsibilities of a project manager? First.
Monitoring,
and controlling. What else?
Planning.
What else?
Cost within the product should be delivered within the cost.
Budget.
Client satisfaction.
Satisfaction. Stakeholder interaction.
Superman. Overall, tissue is Superman or Superwoman.
Stakeholder interaction. What else? Communication. Come on, you're talking
taking
about project manager.
Taking care of quality management also.
Quality. Why you always forget about mentoring and coaching? I don't know.
Normally they don't do that.
So much things.
Yes, so much involved.
So don't you think that agile don't need monitoring and controlling? Then why you are liaised with managers? Tell me. Don't you need monitoring and controlling? Then why you are removing project manager?
We are delegating.
To whom?
To the team.
Yeah. Yes. To the team. Because the development team knows what is the best way to work.
Instead of splitting the work to the team.
So, now this is a big person, lot of activities. Sometimes project manager becomes a blockage for the project because he has to do lot of things. We understand this, And we have divided the responsibilities of a project manager in three roles: planning, monitoring and controlling has given to the development team. Stakeholder interaction and prioritization is given to product owner. Quality is given to the, it depends on to what level you are doing it.
Team also.
Mentoring and coaching gives to Scrum Master. The main thing is that development team does all the monitoring, controlling and planning. Scrum Master does mentoring and coaching, and product owner takes care of all the stakeholder interaction, prioritization. Basically, he owns the product. And in Scrum, we never say that I am a tester, I am a developer, I am a designer. Yes, internally, it can happen because people have their skills. But whenever we deliver as a team. If some issue comes in, we cannot say that nothing comes in testing. I am not responsible. This is past. Past is a story. Live behind it. Product is delivered after the agreement of everyone. Then how tester can say that nothing comes in testing? You agree, yaar. You agree for the delivery. As a whole, you are accountable for the working software. Now, after the combined efforts, you have delivered something. So you cannot communicate whatever you have discussed internally, whatever you have thinking of. It's there means everybody responsible. We cannot give the tag of developer or quality person or a designer. Everybody owns the product collectively. It's a titleless team. Internally it can happen, but they need to collaborate with each other to deliver the working software. That's why sometimes if something, some blockage comes in, some obstacle comes in, even designer can start coding. He is not expected to do coding. But as a team, we have to deliver. I will do anything which is required to meet my goal. I will do anything. I can see only my goal, my team goal. I cannot think about it that I am only developer. All problems comes from the testers. All problems comes from the developers. I cannot say that.
Think this like a startup company, okay? Startup company just started by some partners. Okay, 4 or 5 partners will start a startup company. And there, one partner can't say like, okay, this is your duty. If you are not doing, I am just going to keep mum. Because theirs it is. Right? So everybody will chime in to do any sort of work. So think about that.
Main thing is that if something is delivered, it means there is an agreement. Now you can, after that agreement, you cannot say anything. You cannot say anything. As a developer, as a tester, as a quality analyst. You are the team.